Hey guys, I hope you're having a wonderful Wednesday. As most of you know, Pastor Mike and Bishop have asked me to speak tonight. So we've started a new year, and typically with a new year comes a lot of New Year's resolutions. And the number one resolution is typically losing weight or dieting, right? So that's what we're gonna be talking about today, is dieting. But not necessarily the kind of dieting you're thinking about. So if you would, turn with me in your Bibles to the book of Daniel, chapter 1. And I'm not going to read the whole thing, I'm just going to go over it really quickly. Okay, so we have Daniel, and we have his three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, right? Okay, so Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were all Hebrew boys that were forced from their home to go to the country of Babylon to go serve King Nebuchadnezzar. And King Nebuchadnezzar, we all know he's not the friendliest man, right? But he told all of these Hebrew boys, he was like, look, you're going to eat the food that I give you and drink the drink that I give you, right? But see, there was a big issue because the meat and the wine that King Nebuchadnezzar wanted them to drink was not what they were supposed to be eating and drinking. It would have defiled their bodies according to the Lord. So Daniel decides to go to the chief of staff, and his name was Ashpenaz. And he's like, look, Ashpenaz, please don't make us do this. Look, this is against our religion. This is against what God has told us to do. We can't eat and drink this stuff. And Ashpenaz was like, look, I feel you, bro, but I'm scared of the king. I don't want to get in trouble because you look worse than all the other men. So Daniel was like, okay, look, let's make a deal. Let me, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego eat what we know is approved by God for 10 days. And then compare us to the rest of the men, and if we're not stronger and healthier and probably better looking than all the other men, then fine, we'll eat and drink whatever the king tells us to. And so Ashpenaz agreed. So they ate their vegetables and their water, and everyone else ate on the meat and the wine from the king. And we know after 10 days, they were stronger and healthier than all the other men. So when Ashpenaz presented Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and Daniel to the king, Nebuchadnezzar was so pleased. He was so pleased that he allowed them to continue to eat whatever they wanted for the rest of the time they were there, and he promoted them to high places of authority, right? And so today what I really want to remind you of is your diet, and not necessarily what you're eating or you're drinking, but what we're putting into our minds and in our hearts. So as Christians, we really, really need to be conscious of what we're putting into our minds and into our hearts. We have to be really careful about our diet, our spiritual diet. So my first point tonight is what goes in must come out. See, as humans, our lives are a lot like a sponge. Whatever is inside that sponge is gonna come out once that pressure is applied. So see, if I fill my life up with good, positive things, when the pressure is applied to my life, good and positive things are gonna come out. But if I fill my life up with bad things, sinful things, negative things, then when the pressure is on in my life, that's exactly what's gonna come out. You see, a lot of times we're so busy in life that we don't even realize what we're putting into our minds, into our hearts. See, there's nothing wrong with staying up to date with what's in the world, or, you know, checking social media, checking in with friends, watching a good movie, listening to a good song. See, there's nothing wrong with that. But see, it's how much and the quality of what we're listening to that really, really affects us in our lives. See, even right now, specifically, a lot of us are glued to the news. All we're watching is the news to see what the president said, to see what's going on with the coronavirus, to see this, to see that, and we are glued to that, and we all have our own thoughts and opinions about it, but that's all we're doing is consuming all this information. And some of us, we're not even really interested in the news, but all we do is watch movies, movie after movie after movie, and we watch TV shows, and we binge watch, and whatever the case may be. But see, you have to be on your guard about how much of that you're consuming and the quality of what you're consuming as well. You know, I teach my kids, garbage in, garbage out. What goes in must come out. And you know, that's really just the kid version of, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. See, if we're so busy consuming the things of the world and we're neglecting our spiritual side, then when the pressure's on in life, because the pressure is already on, the pressure's been on all year, right? The past year has been, you know, but once that pressure is applied, that's what's gonna come out of you, what you've been consuming. Do you see what I'm saying? So we have to really be on our guard about what we're putting into our minds, into our hearts. Even as adults, we have to be really careful about that so that good things can come out. And my next point is, even the smallest bit of garbage can hurt you. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so today we're gonna make an ice cream sundae, and I already have my ice cream right here. I don't know about y'all, but I am no simpleton, okay? I like elaborate flavors. I like elaborate toppings. Listen, I'm not simple at all, okay? So I have some of my favorite ice cream here. It's cookies and cream, all right? Just one of the many, many flavors I love. And today, so we're gonna put some toppings on it, right? So I'm one of the weird ones. I love gummy bears, okay? So I put a little bit of gummy bears on top, right? We love the gummies. Love the gummies, right? Okay, so what else? I am a chocolate peanut butter girl, okay? So a little bit of the Reese's Pieces on there. Love these as well. Some of those. Oh, looks so good. Also, again, love the chocolate. You got to have chocolate, okay? This is a must, all right? So we put some chocolate on it too. Just a little bit for the road. All right, so I have some of my favorite toppings on this ice cream, and I'm ready to dig in, but I think it needs just a couple more ingredients. Let's see, what else do I have? Oh yes, we cannot forget a brownie, okay? Again, your girl loves chocolate, all right? So the brownie on it, actually, you know what? Let's crumble that up. Oh yes, Lord. Oh, praise Jesus. Thank you, Father. Shabba-ba. All right, so we have that in. Okay, I don't have any whipped cream, but this is what I do have. Rita Bug, right? So I'm not gonna spray much on here. I'm gonna just a little. All right, that's plenty. That is plenty. Now, let me ask you guys, would you advise that I eat this? Now, all of this goodness is in this bowl, and I'll only put just a little bit of ant and roach killer on it. So, I mean, it's not a lot. Just a little spritz, you know what I'm saying, to give it a little twang, I guess. But would you advise that I eat this? I really pray that most of you guys are saying no right now. Payton, do not eat that. See, I really think that this is a concept that parents know the best. Even a little bit of garbage or even a little bit of sin can hurt you. See, all the time as parents, they're monitoring their kid. They're monitoring what they watch, the music that they listen to, what they read, right? Who their friends are. They're constantly monitoring this stuff. Why? Because they don't want their kids to be watching this, all the cussing and the sexual activity, all the violence, the gore, right? They don't want their kids reading about it or listening to it in songs. And they monitor their friends because they don't want them to have terrible friends, right? So see, parents are constantly on their guard about what their kids are watching. And see, sometimes I feel like as adults, we kind of slip up on that concept because we think as adults, oh, then we can do what we want. We can watch as much news as we want. We can put whatever we want into our eyes and our ears because we're an adult and we know what's wrong. We can go past it, you know. We can see past it. But really, that verse in the Bible, the abundance of the heart the mouth speaks, that's not just for kids. That's for everyone of all ages. So we have to be really careful about what we're consuming with our eyes and our ears, even though we're adults, even though we're full and capable of making choices and decisions on our own. We still have to be constantly on our guard about that, because if you constantly put garbage in, even if it's just a little bit, even if it's just a tiny bit, over time, it will build up and it will hurt you. And my last point is, whatever you feed wins. Okay, so just imagine for a second that you have two dogs, and these dogs fight all the time. And one dog You feed and you water multiple times a day, right? You really take care of this dog. But on the other hand, you have the other dog and you don't really feed it. You don't take it for walks. You don't give it water. You may throw it a bone every once in a while, but that's about it. So when it comes down for these two dogs to fight, which one is gonna win? Obviously the one who's been fed and watered and taken care of, right? See, we all know as humans, we have two sides. We have our physical or our fleshy side, and then we have our spiritual side. Well, whichever side that you feed is gonna win. See, if you're constantly glued to the news and constantly having all of this negativity going into your eyes, into your ears, if you're constantly watching things that you probably shouldn't watch, even as an adult, if you're having friends that are just negative or maybe aren't the most Christian sorts of people that you could be hanging out around, if you are constantly stuck to social media, I know I have this problem. Y'all, one time, I jumped up on my bed, I grabbed my phone, and I just started scrolling through different apps, and I ended up being on social media for 6 hours, and I didn't even know it. I didn't even know it. That's how long I was glued to my phone. You know, you really have to be on your guard about that. What you're putting into your eyes, into your heart, you really have to make sure that you're on a diet, that you're on a spiritual diet. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by CNN, hearing by MSNBC, ABC. No, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. It's okay to stay in touch with the world. It's okay to watch a little bit of the news. It's okay to look on Facebook a little bit. It's okay to, you know, listen to some music, watch some TV, but it's how much and the quality of what you're watching, what you're listening to, what you're allowing your spiritual self to consume into your body. That's really gonna affect the way you handle life's problems. See, I always feel like that we're teaching kids this, right? Be aware of what you're listening to, be aware of what you're reading, be aware of this, be aware of that. But see, then we become adults and we kind of just disregard all that. Oh, I'm an adult, I can look at what I want to, I can watch what I want to, and that may be very true. But as a Christian, that's not necessarily true. So really what I'm doing is I just want to encourage you today to maybe start a new New Year's resolution and start a diet, but not necessarily, you know, the physical diet, but a spiritual diet. Let's make a decision. In 2021, we are going to diet. We are going to rid ourselves of all of this gunk, and we are gonna feed that spiritual side. And so when storms come in life, when things happen to us, then we can take it on with no issue. We can trust God and we can apply our faith. See, with all that gunk, we can't really use our faith because it just creates a whole bunch of doubt. And we know if you're doubting, your faith ain't working, right? So let's choose. 2021 is gonna be the best year yet, and we are gonna go on a spiritual diet. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. But before we go, we are gonna say our confession of faith. This is how I end any and all of my services, all of my videos, anytime that I minister. I always have the congregation say this confession of faith with me. So just repeat after me. Jesus is Lord of my life. I am led by the Spirit, fed by the Word, live by faith, and walk in love. In Jesus, I'm wealthy, well, and wise, protected by His blood, blessed, not cursed. His grace is sufficient for me. His will is my pleasure, and His cross is my victory. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you have a tremendous week, and we'll see you Sunday.